My grandson, Kale, saw it coming. That's the part that breaks my heart the most.
By the time this family of four saw a car speeding toward them, it was too late. Investigators say a drunk driver plowed right into their utility vehicle, killing mom, Kaylee Hampton, and her 13-year-old son, Kale. Her husband and other son survived with serious injuries. And now, more than a year later, DeSoto County deputies have arrested this man, Garrett Edwards, for DUI and manslaughter. Only NBC2's Samantha Serban is talking with the family who has been waiting for justice.
I never thought it would take a year.
The heartache of losing her family is hitting Kathy Kale Griffin hard today. It's been a year since her daughter and grandson were killed. Let me take you back to September 2nd, 2022. Kaylee, Kale, and their other family members lived on a rural county road where Griffin says her daughter saw Garrett Edwards speeding all the time.
She would yell at him, "You're gonna kill somebody one day," not knowing that he was gonna be killing her and her son.
The family was on their Gator, straddling the shoulder on their way home from the creek. A new FHP report shows a car came flying at them and slammed into them from behind. Troopers say Garrett Edwards was behind the wheel of that car.
He never hit the brakes, and he hit them doing 93 in a 45.
The FHP report shows Edwards' top speed in the 5 seconds before the crash was 95 miles an hour. His blood alcohol, more than twice the legal limit, coming in at 0.183.
And the sad part about it was, one of his friends that had been drinking with him all day long took him to his grandmother's house, put him on the couch, and left, thinking he was home safe, he was fine. This fool decided to get up, get the set of keys to the car that he was allowed to drive, and get in it and go around the curve and kill my family.
Griffin said investigators told her Edwards wasn't arrested at the scene because he had to go to the hospital. Troopers also said they needed to complete their investigation in case Edwards demanded a speedy trial. The warrant was signed on Kaylee's birthday.
Come to find out, his birthday is also September the 28th. Now when I remember her special day, our special day, the day of her birth, I remember that's the day of his birth.
Griffin says Edwards was told to turn himself in at midnight, but he never showed up. He did end up going to the sheriff's office himself, but only after deputies posted his photo on social media as a wanted man. Count on NBC2 to keep you updated as Edwards faces arraignment next month. I'm local in DeSoto County. Samantha Serban, NBC2.